Hey ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Ordinary E. Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to do something a little different. If you haven't already, like and subscribe. So, as you know, I was fortunate enough to get a PlayStation 5. I hope you guys are having luck as well getting a PlayStation 5. But yes, the dreaded drift happened on my original controller after 1 month. So just a month, and the analog stick started to drift. I think on the original was going up. So you can use the PlayStation 4 controllers, but you can only play PlayStation 4 games. But I want to use a. So I decided to go on eBay and see if I can get a second PlayStation 5 controller, because it's good to have two anyway, right? And so I managed to get this eBay controller, this PlayStation 5 off eBay for £26, and there was no description that anything was wrong with it, but it arrived, it was all packaged very well, bubble wrapped and everything, but straight off the bat I noticed something odd with this trigger here, and there's a little rattle as well. So this trigger wasn't functioning properly, and possibly this one as well. And then I decided to plug it in and see if it all functioned all right before I contacted the seller. And this controller has drift as well. So this one goes to the left or to the right. So I have no controllers. I contacted the seller. The guy, I said I'll return it for a refund, but the guy said just keep it. So what I'm going to do in this video is see if we can fix it. And I'm going to take you along so that you could possibly learn how to fix it if you encounter the same thing. I've never taken this apart before. I've never taken a PlayStation 5 controller apart before. I've never tried to fix it, but let's figure out what that rattle is. So there's definitely a broken part inside. Don't know what it is. And yeah, let's get into it. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to try and fix whatever's broken inside and try and fix drift. Now obviously to fix drift is going to be, I'll show you the component once we get in there, but yeah, let's get into it. So I'm going to need a few tools. I'm going to use that. And that to catch any screws, and yeah, let's see how we go. So the first thing you need is a prying tool. I'm just going to use that, see how we go. And I think the first thing you do is you just unclip the back here. So I'm just going to put a tool in there and pop that off. Yep, that works. It's on the other side as well. And then that comes off slightly, and then you've got to be careful here because these bits tuck inside. I have watched videos, so that's how I know, but these bits tuck inside, so let's see if we can just ease that off a bit. This all just unclipped. Okay, just want to be a bit careful, get stuck on the analog. Okay, all right, that comes off. And you can get replacement parts. You can get these replacement parts, different colours and whatnot. What I do want to do is change this back, because although it's nice and grippy here, there's some nice rubber backs you can get. I feel better that I think anyway. But so I'm going to try and get some of that and show you how to change those. That exposes two screws on the very bottom. Let's see. Do with that. Yeah. Small screwdriver. I think I'm used to using something like this. Let's check. Yeah, that seems to be alright. So, we've got a screw either end of here. Let's just take that off. two screws done, and then I believe there's two screws underneath these triggers. So all I'm going to do for the triggers is to put the prying tool under that one there and just pop the, it's going to be the R1 and the L1. See if they just pops off. Yeah. Like so. So obviously they're going to, yeah, they're just going to go flying all over the place, so that's cool. That exposes another two screws inside there. You can see. You'll see them anyway. The two top screws. I'm just going to unscrew those. You've got the wrong size. Okay. Work on the other ones. Too big. Try this one. So because it's free, I've got the you know, the luxury of being able to do this, because he gave me a refund and told me to keep it. So that's why I'm taking it apart. Otherwise, I'd be very worried and I'm probably going to break it anyway. But see if I can fix it. So once you get to that part, there's four screws you've taken off. Then you should be able to just, yeah, there's two clips at the very bottom. So we're just going to pop those clips first, very gently, so I don't want those clips to break. And lift that up slightly above so it doesn't clip back. And then that should release slightly. You can see the gap now. And then I'm just going to go around the side and just see if I can unclip the side clips. There you go. It's not too bad. Very gently, no pressure, no additional force needed, and that's just released it. So that should lift off. Oh yeah, okay. That's the inside of that part. A bit of a cushion, and the battery. And now let's just see if there's anything loose. You can see that trigger is lower. Let's see what was rattling. I think there. Hear that rattle? Oh! Something just popped up. Ha ha! Oh, I know these. So that's a... That's a spring, but it's only half a spring. I don't know if it's going to focus, but yeah, that spring is, maybe that's how they are on the PlayStation 5s. Where did that come from? Oh, I see, yeah. So the other side has a spring, the same as that. And this one doesn't have one, so it must have come from the trigger. And yeah, so it looks like this is half of the spring. I think I remember these from PlayStation 4 controllers. So okay, where would that go? That one's on the inside. And then this one doesn't have the same configuration. So if you see, this inside has the spring, on the L, what, 2 button. But then on the inside of this one doesn't have the same, you know, configuration. So I think the problem is this spring, okay? And, oh. Okay, so the outside, oh, I see. All right. So the outside of the L2 and the outside of the R2 are the same, and the inside of the L2 and the outside of the R2 is the same. Is it R2? Yeah. And then the outside of the L2, but the inside of the R2 is different. So I think the spring would go on the outside here. And, oh boy, have you seen that? There's a lot of cabling. There's a lot more. I've taken apart the PS4 controllers, and there was a lot more going on in here than there is on the PS4. But anyway, let's see if we can put a spring back on the trigger. Yeah, so this springs back. This one still springs back. It's not as snappy, maybe. But yeah, I definitely felt a difference in the game when I was trying to use it. Okay, so we need a spring. And I think I remember seeing those in a PlayStation 4 controller, so I'm gonna go and get a PlayStation 4 controller. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I've got a PlayStation 4 controller here. Let's see if we can salvage a spring. This one works fine. No, actually, I think the trigger doesn't work anyway. So, let's see if we can salvage a spring from the PS4. I don't know if it's the same springs. They look familiar, it looks the same. I remember them being the same as that, maybe. We'll see. You know how to take apart a PlayStation 4 controller by now. It's 4 screws at the back. You lift the handles up. They just pop off. Then you unclip the battery. Like so. Huh? I think the battery was pretty good. Okay, so there's the springs on here. So the springs on here on the inside. Let's try and get one of those out. See, we've done these the same. So the same, the inside of here and the inside of here are the same, but the outside and the outside are the same. But they didn't do that on the PlayStation 5 controllers. Yeah, it looks the same. Just gonna have to get in there. Have to get stuck behind a post, you know, the screw post. Spring should look like, and they're the same, apart from this one's only half of one spring. Yeah, exactly the same. So we can use PlayStation 4 spring. There you go. And I'll put that in the PS5. That should fix the trigger. Now, how does this go in? So I guess it just loops in there. So what I've done is there's a hook there's a hook, plastic hook here, so I put the hoop on the plastic hook. This bottom piece looks like it just sits. Dropped off the hook. Hold on. These things don't grip in. I'll just use my fingers. Hope you can see this what I'm doing, guys. Hook that on over. I think this comes down and under the trigger. Ah, yeah, that was sitting there. Okay. So I just got to grab this top part and bring it down under the trigger. Yes. Alright, that's in. Yep, and that's flipping it back up. Sharpish. So, I don't know if you can see that, if it's going to focus. But, I just put the PS4 spring. Fits perfectly. And now the trigger works. Pretty good. So, the next thing to do is to try and fix the drift. So, for that, I think I'm going to disconnect the battery first. Out the batteries of problem. Is there an easier way of doing this? Do you know? Let me know. At least I hate taking the batteries off the PS4. If I can do it. They don't come out easy. I don't want to mess up all the plastic. Okay, let's do it side by side. Plastic out, what I did was pull it from one side and the other side and the other side slowly. It's come out, the pins look good. Oh boy, there's a lot of connections. But what we want to do is get to the analog. So I think it was drifting. I can't remember now. But I think. Was it this drifting? That's the ground test. The there's actually a software you can do to test it, right? Alright, so now we know it's the left stick and it goes to the left. So I'm just going to mark that one here, just so I know. It's sad. Alright, let's get into it. So, let's take the battery back out again. I've got the battery off. There's another screw in the middle there for that plate there. And unfortunately, we're going to have to go all the way down to the bottom of this controller. Go in there. Does that come off? It does. No, it's clipped in. So that's just a ribbon cable. This is going to be finicky to get back together. Okay, so I've got that part away. Another ribbon cable here. Sides. Should just pull out. Do I actually need to take it off? Don't know. Let's see. They come off. All right. So 1, 2, 3, 4 ribbon cables. Another one at the top, 5 ribbon cables. All right. So these are red and white cables that connect the vibrator and gizmos. They are pretty short. There's a couple of more screws here, but I don't know if that needs to come off. Those need to come off. Let's have a look. I think that should come out, right? Another two screws either side here. One this side. Take these two screws as well. Oh no, we didn't. We just want to get to this board. So we just want to get to this. Market, so it's this side on the right. So it's this one here. Does this come off? Yep, so the joypad comes off. Easy enough. Okay, so this is the controller that goes left and right, and this one goes up and down. And you can see when you twist it left and right, up and down, it's these. I don't know if you can get in there, but I'll try and bring you down. Is it the analog stick that's causing drift? Now when you turn this one left and right, you can see there's the white. That white part moves and that white part moves on the other side. So when you turn it to the left or right, this one moves. And we need to go up and down, this one moves. So because it's the left, stick that's going to the left, so it's this one here that's causing the problem. So we're going to try and open that or change it, or maybe desolder it and change it, because I do have these, because I tried to fix them on part on the PlayStation 4. So yeah, so this is the culprit right here. It doesn't look to be any dust or dirt, which is what I would check for first, but we're going to try and get this off and have a look at that. Three soldering points to take off. So I need a soldering iron. Okay. Okay, so I've got my soldering iron kit. It's very old. It's a very big tip. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to get in there. So I'm trying to use this magnifying glass that I got to fix the motherboards with. If you saw my last videos. So hopefully I can use this, but the light is shining on it. We've got to get in there. Just take off three parts of pits of solder. So this gizmo here, once you've pulled it out, should take it off. Alright, we're all set up now. Let's see if we can do this. Should get a bit of sponge. Yeah. pants on. I feel like. Maybe I should take some off of here first. Move it. Okay, well, just taking it out. There doesn't seem to be any damage, but there's a lot of dirt. The dirt, I don't know what that is. Possibly. There doesn't seem to be anything. Oh yeah, so the ring is completely worn away. I see it. So yeah, this gizmo is completely done in. Alright, so I've managed to get it out, and you can see in there, if it focuses, you can see the circle parts, they've worn away. Now I do have some that I bought years ago for the PlayStation 4. I got drift on the PlayStation 4 as well. They really should invent better joysticks, right? But they look the same. Ladies and gentlemen, sorry about that. I had to, my memory card was full, so I had to save what I did and format that. But here we are back at this. I'm not sure quite where it was, but I was just showing you that I've managed to take off the part. You can just see in there that the black rings, they're worn away. So now I'm going to change that, and that is underneath this little part here. Let me take that away. Now, I don't know if I said already, but I did buy some of these for the PS4. Back in the day, and I've had them ever since, so they look exactly the same. I'm going to see if I can use one of these now on this. I did even fix my PS4 one, but it's exactly the same as that. Same colours, same everything. The only thing that's different. Try this off. That's the one we want. move in with it. Now we've got to do is solder those legs back down.
Okay, it's almost the perfect size. Plug in my soldering iron. I need a better soldering iron. If you recommend, if you know a better soldering iron than that, let me know, because this one is literally had it. Gonna need some solder. Which I have here. And hopefully this will work. Okay, we should be hot enough. I did go and sand this tip down. Yeah. So now I wanna coat it with solder. Okay, that's done. Let's see if it will put it back together and fire it up.
Wires, so hopefully they don't interfere with anything. Should be alright. Another good part of remembering how it went back together. So first things first, and then this. What do you think, guys? Is it going to work? Am I able to repair a PS5 controller? Clicking. I'm going to just break it more. Something's missing here. So this piece here went on. Just sits in there, so I don't know what that thing is, but I'm gonna just put that in there. Double check everything goes in the right point. So the ribbon cable here, ribbon cable there, two, there was five, wasn't there? Ribbon cable back down here, ribbon cable back here. The other one's on the battery, okay. So we're gonna put that back in. And to hold it down, I think we can put this on as well. Yeah, but actually I'm gonna put this ribbon cable at the top on. So I'm going to put these on the side. A little tougher to get in. so. So I put the two ribbon cables on the sides on, and the one on the top. Now the little ones on the bottom. So we can put that one in like so. Then I'm going to put the battery on with a screw. Go in, so let's put that in. That's the five, so that's the last one. Let's come out of there again, like that. Is that okay? Just makes it easier for me to put this in. The battery. So not too difficult. I can't remember which way the battery went. That pin's on the other side, so it's this way. Press down. All right. Fingers crossed, guys. We should have a repaired. I've probably burnt everything while I'm doing the soldering, but I should have a repaired controller. I'm hoping. Let's put this on and let's test it. Clicks and get a cable so we can put this away. Keep everything nice and tidy, just like me. Why do I have screws? 1, 2, 3, 4. I have two screws over. Oh, the side screws, guys. I forgot about those two side screws. I'll pull them in a minute. Let's test it first. Remember how to test it? Control panel. We even need an announcement. Hardware, devices, the controller should show up. It does, good sign. Controller settings, and then properties. Alright. Oh yes. Oh yes. So, I'll bring you down. Remember, when I press to the left, that wasn't working, but it was drifting to the left, so it's fixed, and that's all you have to do. And if I do the right is good as well. So good news, no more drift. Excellent. Let me put the controller back together. I've got to put those two screws I missed. down the sights. Bit easier. That comes off, make sure that comes back in. So, the two screws that we missed are on the sides. Find the buttons because they went flying. Just make sure no cables are going to get caught and close it. Like so. Start putting the screws back in, so let's do the top ones. So that was pretty simple, guys, right? If I could do it, anyone can do it. Hopefully you have a better soldering iron than I do. If you want to see me repair anything else, I have to break it first, but yeah, I'm sure this stuff breaks and I'll try and repair it and show you. Got one of the buttons here. I'll just pop back on. I'll find the other one. Went down here. All you do is just find the right. Well, no, don't force anything, it should just pop in and then a bit of pressure, that's it, and then it clicks in. They feel good, just wipe off my mark that I put on there. And then this thing, just be careful with this, because they need to go in there, right? I'm probably going to snap those things, look at those. There we have it. I should have one fully working controller. What do you think, guys? Is the job okay done? Hopefully you could follow along. I know I don't have the camera to show you close up and everything I was doing, but hopefully you understand what I did there. Yeah, so successful job. Let me know what you think. If you enjoyed that, let me know.
Don't forget to subscribe. You guys need to subscribe, please. And hit the like button if you like. And I'll see you on the next video. See you later.